These two statements over here may seem obvious to you, but proving them might be not that easy. Well, try it yourself and see whether you did it correctly using this video. So what do we have? We have two subsets of Rn, V and W. And first of all, V is a subset of W. We know that W is independent, so the big set is independent. And then we have to show that the smaller set is independent as well. So you pick a big set, independent, pick some vectors of them. And you have to show that this smaller set is also independent. Or the other statement, again, V is a subset of W, but now the big set is dependent. And what happens if you pick a smaller set? Is the smaller set then always also dependent? That's the second statement. Well, let's have a look. First, we look at statement one, and we try to prove that if you have a big set which is independent, now if you take a smaller set, that the smaller set is still independent. Well, a first proof could go like this. So we have some big set consisting of two vectors. We take some subset. Then we see, V is a subset of W. We see W is independent. The vectors are not a multiple of each other. V is independent, contains only one vector. So we can now conclude that statement one is correct. Well, there is an error in one of those steps. But what step is actually wrong? Well, steps two, you can pick a W like that, you can pick a V like that. Step two is also correct, all the statements are fine. However, you can't conclude from an example that the general statement is correct. So that means that the third step is wrong. You cannot draw this general conclusion from one example. So let's give it a second try. So we take some set W consisting of m vectors. So they are live both in Rn, so you need less vectors than n, because in Rn you have at most n independent vectors. So we take m vectors in W, and then your V is a subset of your W, so you take, say, the first k vectors. You can do this without lots of generality. If V has to be some subset, you just order the vectors in such a way that you have the first k vectors for your set V. So that's fine. Even though, of course, V is smaller than W, so contains less vectors, so K has to be smaller or equal than M. Now, suppose now, on the contrary, that V is dependent. So we want to show that V is independent, but now suppose V is dependent. Then you know that at least one of the vectors of V is a linear combination of the other vectors of V. And without loss of generality, you can assume that that vector is the first vector. So you know W1 is a linear combination of W2 up to Wk. Then step four, in our big set W, we can find the same dependent relation, namely, please add something here. And this implies that W is dependent, which is contradicting our what's given, namely that W is independent. So that means that our assumption in step two over here, what we suppose is wrong. Our assumption that V is dependent is incorrect, so we can conclude that V is independent. So here's a second proof of statement one. And is this proof correct, or are there some errors in some of the steps? Well, this one is quite tricky, because is it correct or not? It depends. Depends on how you define independence of a set. Like, if you define independence, it's possible, as that one of the vectors is, that at least one of the vectors is a linear combination of the others, then everything is totally fine. But if you don't define dependence like this, then actually, in this step two over here, you use the theorem. And in step five, you also use the theorem. And the question is to use the relevant definitions to prove the statement. So if your definition is a different one, namely a set is dependent if V1 up to Cn, Vn is zero, only has a trivial solution. If you have that definition for dependence of a set, then actually this proof it's not fully correct because you're using theorems in the proof and not the definitions. Furthermore, further on, the whole proof is fine. So let's try now to give the proof of the statement using the definitions. So same first step. So a W consists of m vectors, m smaller or equal than n, and V is a subset of that, or them such that they are just the first k vectors of your bigger set. Now, it's given that W is independent, so you know that this equation over here only has a trivial solution. And then we have to prove that V is independent, so we have to prove that this equation over here only has a trivial solution. Now, how are we going to do that? Now, we suppose on the contrary that this equation over here has a non-trivial solution. So you have weights C1 up to CK, which are not all zero, such that this equation over here equals zero. If you have that, then the equation double star also has a non-trivial solution, namely, please add the steps. But that means that you find a non-trivial solution of the equation over here, which means that your W is dependent, which is contradicting what is given in step two. So that's not correct. So our assumption here, suppose, is incorrect, which means that we can conclude that V is independent. Now, question, is this proof now fully correct? Starting with the definitions. Yes, now we are done. We are nicely using the definitions and concluding that if the big set is independent, then also the smaller set is independent, which hopefully coincides with your intuition. Now the other one. Suppose V is a subset of W and now W is dependent. Do we now know that V is also dependent? Well, that's easy. That's not true. You can easily find a counterexample yourself. Just pick any dependent set for W, throw out all vectors except for one. Then your new set V is a subset of W but is independent and not dependent. So the statement 2 is actually much easier to prove because it's not true, so you can easily disprove it using a counterexample.